गुड मॉर्निंग डियर फ्रेंड्स। जैसे कि हम जानते हैं, अकॉर्डिंग टू द एनसीईआरटी बुक्स क्लास 12th, इट कंप्राइजेस फर्स्ट टॉपिक विथ फोर चैप्टर्स। द फर्स्ट यूनिट दैट वी हैव टू स्टडी इन स्टैंडर्ड 12th, द फर्स्ट यूनिट इट इज रिप्रोडक्शन, एंड फ्रॉम रिप्रोडक्शन वी हैव टू स्टडी फोर डिफरेंट टॉपिक्स। फर्स्ट टॉपिक इट इज जनरल रिप्रोडक्शन इन केस ऑफ ऑर्गेनिजम्स। Second topic, how reproduction it occurs in case of plants. Third topic, it deals with complete human reproduction. And fourth topic, it deals with reproductive health. Now, out of these four topics that we have to study under the unit reproduction, now today we will discuss about the topic how reproduction it specially occurs in case of flowering plants. Rest of the type of reproduction occurring in case of plant we will discuss in the first topic, that is reproduction in organisms. Okay? Now going back to standard 11th, now in standard 11th, you have dealt with the topic angiospermic plant. Now in standard 11th, we have studied morphology of angiospermic plant. Now morphology means the different external characters which are observed in case of angiospermic plant. Now moving to the study of plants. Now we are very familiar, very well known that five different group of plants, they are found growing on the surface of the earth. First group, algae. Second group, bryophytes. Third group, pteridophytes. Fourth group, gymnosperms. And fifth group, they are the angiosperms. Now, out of these five group of plants, angiosperms, they are the only group of plants which produce flowers. So, angiosperms, they are also called as flowering plants. And the topic, it is named as sexual reproduction in flowering plants, or we can also call it as reproduction in angiospermic plant or sexual reproduction in angiosperms. Now moving on to our topic, sexual reproduction in case of flowering plants. Now for the purpose of sexual reproduction, the angiospermic plant, they produce a special structure. Now this structure, it is called as flower. So flower, it is a specialized organ found in case of angiospermic plant, which is responsible to perform the process of sexual reproduction. Now looking after the science of a flower, the science of cultivation, breeding and marketing of flowers, now it is also called as floriculture. So seeing the scientific view of a flower produced by angiosperm, the science of cultivation, breeding as well as marketing of a flower. Now such a science of a flower, it is also called as an floriculture. Now if we find the Indian view about the flower, for Indian people, flower is an organ of aesthetic, ornamental, social, cultural and religious value. For we people, especially we Indian people, flower, it has aesthetic, ornamental, social, cultural as well as religious value. Agar hum log apni drishtikon se dekhte hain, फ्लावर को काफी महत्व दिया गया है. फ्लावर इट इज एन ऑर्गन ऑफ एस्थेटिक. एस्थेटिक मीन्स इट इज एन ऑर्गन ऑफ ब्यूटी. देखने के बाद काफी अच्छा लगता है, बहुत सुंदर दिखता है, काफी अट्रैक्टिव होता है. सो इट इज एन ऑर्गन ऑफ एस्थेटिक. इट इज एन ऑर्गन ऑफ ऑर्नामेंटल वैल्यूज. कोई भी फंक्शन है हमारे घर में, शादी है, किसी का बर्थडे है, कोई भी सुख का समारोह है, ऐसे वक्त में फ्लावर को काफी महत्व होता है. सजावट के लिए, स्पेशली फॉर डेकोरेटिंग और सराउंडिंग, वी मेक यूज ऑफ फ्लावर. सो इट हैज एन ऑर्नामेंटल वैल्यू. फ्लावर इट हैज सोशल वैल्यू. फ्लावर इट हैज कल्चरल वैल्यू. फ्लावर इट हैज रिलीजियस वैल्यू. सोशल, सामाजिक महत्व है उसको. कल्चरल, हमारा सांस्कृतिक महत्व है उसको. और रिलीजियस, जो भी हम लोग धार्मिक फंक्शंस करते हैं, मंदिरों में जाए, मस्जिदों में जाए, वहां भी फूलों को काफी इंपॉर्टेंस है. सो on the basis of Indian people view, it has aesthetic, ornamental, social, cultural as well as religious value. Now moving in the view of a biologist, So what do biologists they think about the flower? स्पेशली अगर बायोलॉजी के दृष्टिकोण से हम लोग देखते हैं फ्लावर के बारे में, तो एक बायोलॉजी पर्सन के लिए और बॉटनिस्ट पीपल के लिए, ऐसा व्यक्ति जो प्लांट के बारे में पढ़ता है, प्लांट के बारे में पढ़ाता है, उसके एंगल से अगर हम लोग देखते हैं ना, बाय द व्यू ऑफ अ बायोलॉजिस्ट, ए फ्लावर इट इज अ मॉर्फोलॉजिकल एंड एम्ब्रियोलॉजिकल marvel found in case of angiospermic plant which is specially designed for the purpose of sexual reproduction. Specially designed for the purpose of a sexual reproduction. Dosto sexual reproduction kaise hota hai usko detail mein padhne se pehle hum log dekhenge flower which is an organ of a sexual reproduction in case of angiosperm. एक टिपिकल फ्लावर में कौन कौन सी चीजें होती हैं, अब मॉर्फोलॉजी ऑफ फ्लावरिंग प्लांट्स में आपने काफी डिटेल पढ़ा है फ्लावर के बारे में, यू हैव स्टडीड इन डिटेल रिगार्डिंग स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ फ्लावर व्हाइल स्टडीइंग मॉर्फोलॉजी ऑफ फ्लावरिंग प्लांट्स इन योर क्लास 11. टुडे वी विल जस्ट रिव्यू सम इंपॉर्टेंट पॉइंट्स अबाउट द फ्लावर दैट यू माइट हैव मिस्ड व्हाइल स्टडीइंग स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ फ्लावर ड्यूरिंग योर 11th क्लास. नाउ फ्लावर विच इज एन ऑर्गन ऑफ सेक्सुअल रिप्रोडक्शन. Now the most typical plant which is used for study of angiospermic character or the plant which shows a typical angiospermic character. Now this plant which is most widely studied for studying morphological characters, capsella, also called as shepherd's purse. Capsella, or it is also called as shepherd's purse, which is the most typical plant showing angiospermic character. Now, capsella, it is an annual plant, specially found growing during winter season as weeds in field. It may be the field of potato. It may be in the field of wheat, so they are found growing as a weed, and they are found growing vigorously in the fields of potato, in the fields of a wheat. So capsella, it is an annual plant. Annual plant means the plant which complete their life cycle within a year. Such type of plants they are called as an annual plants. Now the main plant body of a capsula, it is sporophytic. Sporophytic means main plant body it is diploid, differentiated into root, stem as well as leaves. It is differentiated into root, stem as well as leaves, and this is capsula, they are heterosporous plant. Now heterosporous means they produce two different types of spores. They are responsible to produce two different types of spores. First type of spores which are produced, they are called as microspores, and second type of spores which are produced, they are called as megaspores. Now always remember, term micro in biology it indicates male, and term mega in case of biology it indicates female. Now these two words they also have another meaning, but regarding reproduction, micro means male, mega means female. So microspore means male spore, and megaspore it means female spores. So capsula is a typical angiospermic plant which is used to study typical angiospermic character. It may be morphological character or it may be reproductive characters. Okay, got up clear? Now we will move to the main organ of sexual reproduction, that is called as flower. Now according to scientist Goethe, flower, it is a modified shoot. Or it is a modified stem. The typical definition of a flower, flower, it is a modified shoot or modified stem. Now modification means stem, it has undergone structural as well as functional changes. Now this is called as a modification, and this modification which is observed in case of stem. Now this modification, it is specially for the purpose of sexual reproduction. So flower, it is also defined as a modified and condensed shoot specially designed for the purpose of sexual reproduction. Now you have studied the structure of a typical flower. A typical flower, it consists of a stalk. The stalk of a flower, it is also called as pedicel. Now there are certain flowers in which stalk it is absent. On the basis or presence or absence of stalk, flower, it may be described as a flower having a stalk. Such type of flower, it is called as pedicellate flower. And flower in which stalk it is absent, such type of flower, they are also called as sessile flower. Okay, so typical flower, it consists of a stalk. Stalk of a flower, it is called as a pedicel. Now free end of a pedicel, or tip of a pedicel, the free end of pedicel or tip of a pedicel, it is flattened or dome shaped. And this is flattened or a dome shaped free end or tip of a pedicel. Now this is structure, it is called as thalamus. Now seeing the structure of a typical flower, a typical flower, it consists of a stalk. Now this is stalk of a typical flower, it is called as pedicel. And the free end or the tip of a pedicel, which is flattened or dome shaped, that free end, it is called as a thalamus. Now thalamus, it is a flattened or dome shaped part of a pedicel which consists of nodes and internodes. Now as we know, presence of nodes and internodes, it is a characteristic feature of a flower. It is a characteristic feature of a stem. Now as there is a presence of nodes and internodes on a thalamus flower, it is considered as a modified shoot, or it is also considered as a modified stem. Now thalamus, it consists of four nodes. And in case of thalamus, the internodes, they are highly reduced or they are small. Now as internodes, they are highly reduced and small. The nodes, they are present very close to each other. Now the four nodes which are present, now these four nodes, they give rise to floral whorls. Now these floral whorls, they are nothing but they are the modified leaves. So thalamus, it consists of four nodes. All the four nodes, they are closely present between each other, and they are closely located near each other. It is because that internodes, they are highly reduced or they are very small in a size. And each node, it gives rise to floral whorl. Now these floral whorls of a flower, they are nothing but they are the modified leaves. The outermost node or lowermost, it gives rise to first floral whorl. Now this first floral whorl, it is also called as calyx. And unit of a calyx, they are also called as sepals. Normally flowers, they consist of 3 to 5 sepals. Okay, that might you have discussed in 11th standard. Inner node to outermost or second node, it gives rise to second floral whorl. And this is second floral whorl, it is called as corolla. And as we know, unit of a corolla, it is also called as petal. Third node, it gives rise to third floral whorl. Now this third floral whorl, it is called as androecium. And androecium, the unit of androecium, it is called as an stamen. Now androecium, it is a male reproductive organ of the flower. Androecium, it is a male reproductive organ of the flower. And the fourth or innermost node, or we can also call it as topmost node. It gives rise to fourth floral whorl. Now this fourth floral whorl, it is called as gynoecium. Unit of a gynoecium, it is called as carpel, or it is also called as pistil, which functions as female reproductive organ. Clear? So presence of nodes and internodes on a thalamus, it shows that flower, it is a modified shoot or it is a modified stem. Now normally the number of nodes which are present on thalamus, there are 4 in numbers. Internodes, as they are highly reduced, small in size, these nodes, they are present close to each other. Each node present on thalamus, it gives rise to floral whorls. These floral whorls, they are nothing but they are the modified leaves. As we have discussed, the outermost or lowermost floral whorl, it is responsible to give rise to first modified leaf or floral whorl. It is called as calyx. Second, it gives rise to corolla. Third, it gives rise to androecium. And fourth node, it gives rise to gynoecium. Now moving to the structure of a typical flower. Now all these floral whorls, they are arranged in a circle. And their arrangement, it is always specific from outer towards the inner side. The outermost floral whorl, it is calyx, unit of a calyx, it is called as a sepal. Inner to calyx, second floral whorl, it is present. That second floral whorl, it is called as corolla. Unit of a corolla, it is called as a petal. Third floral whorl, inner to corolla, there is a presence of third floral whorl. Now this is third floral whorl, it is also called as an androecium. Unit of androecium, it is called as an stamen. And the innermost floral whorl, that is called as carpel or pistil. It is gynoecium. Unit of gynoecium, it is called as carpel or pistil. So four nodes, they give rise to four floral whorls, always arranged in a specific manner from outer to inner side. Calyx, corolla, androecium and gynoecium. Now the arrangement of these floral whorls, it never changes. Outermost, it is calyx, unit of calyx, sepal. Inner to calyx, corolla, unit of corolla, petal. Inner to corolla, androecium, unit of androecium, correct, stamen. Fourth, gynoecium, unit of gynoecium, it is called as an carpel. Now flower, which is an organ of sexual reproduction. Now in this flower, two important whorls, androecium and gynoecium. Now these two whorls, they are also called as essential whorls. You might remember the four floral whorls are classified as accessory whorls as well as essential whorls. Calyx and corolla, as they are not directly involved in sexual reproduction, they just help in sexual reproduction. So these whorls, they are also called as accessory whorls. While androecium and gynoecium, they actually take part in the process of sexual reproduction. So these whorls, they are also called as essential whorls. Okay. So these are the four floral whorls. Out of these four floral whorls, two they are accessory and two they are essential. Now moving to some of the important terms that you might have not studied. In 11th standard, by studying morphology of flowers. Now as discussed earlier, the four nodes present on thalamus, they are located closely to each other. They are located closely to each other. But in case of some plants, distance they are present in different nodes. For example, if internode, it is large between first and second node. Or we can discuss in another term, if length of internode between calyx and corolla, it increases. The length of internode between calyx and corolla, it increases. Now this condition, it is also called as anthophore. This condition is also called as an anthophore. Agar calyx aur corolla ke beech mein internode ki size thodi si badh gayi hai, jiski wajah se calyx aur corolla ke beech mein distance aa gaya hai, such a condition it is referred to as anthophore. And such a condition it is found in case of silene plant dianthus, is there is increase in the length of internode between first and second node, that is calyx as well as corolla, then such a condition is called as an anthophore, and such a condition it is found in case of silene plant, it is found in case of dianthus. Another condition, if length of internode between corolla and androecium, it is more. Now such a condition it is called as androphore. Example, it is Passiflora, Krishna Kamal. Agar corolla or androecium ke beech mein distance jyada hai, internode ki length badh gayi hai, to uske wajah se corolla aur androecium ke beech mein kafi gap rahega, and this condition it is referred to as androphore, and such a condition it is found in case of flower, that is called as an Passiflora. Third condition, if length of internode between androecium and gynoecium, it is more. Now such a condition is called as gynophore. It is found in case of a plant called as Caparis. Found in case of plant that is called as an Caparis. ठीक है, फिर से इसको हम लोग रिवाइज करते हैं. नॉर्मली चारों नोड्स ये एक दूसरे के काफी नजदीक होते हैं, लेकिन कुछ प्लांट्स में दो नोड के बीच में इंटर नोड की लेंथ की इंक्रीज हो सकती है. फॉर एग्जाम्पल, पहला प्लांट जो हमने देखा है साइलिन प्लांट और डायंसस में, अगर हम लोग देखते हैं तो कैलिक्स और करोला के बीच में का जो इंटर नोड है उसकी लेंथ बढ़ चुकी है, ऐसे कंडीशन को हम लोग क्या बोलेंगे, एंथोफोर. इफ लेंथ ऑफ इंटर नोड बिटवीन करोला एंड एंड्रोशियम, करोला और एंड्रोशियम के बीच में जो इंटर नोड है उसकी लेंथ अगर बढ़ गई है, सच कंडीशन इज कॉल्ड एज एंड्रोफोर. इसका एग्जाम्पल है पैसीफ्लोरा. सेम कंडीशन, इफ लेंथ ऑफ इंटर नोड बिटवीन एंड्रोशियम एंड गाइनोशियम इट इंक्रीजेस, एंड्रोशियम और गाइनोशियम के बीच में की इंटर नोड की लेंथ अगर बढ़ गई है, ऐसे कंडीशन को हम लोग क्या बोलेंगे, गाइनोफोर. इसका एग्जाम्पल क्या है, कैपरिस. Now if androphore and gynophore, if androphore and gynophore they are found in same flower, if androphore and gynophore they are found in a same flower, androphore means length of internode between corolla and androecium is more, this condition is called as an androphore. Okay? And gynophore means length of internode between androecium and gynoecium is more. If both the condition they are found in case of flame flower, then this condition it is called as gynandrophore, or this condition it is also called as androgynophore. And this condition it is found in case of plant, Gynandropsis pentaphylla. It is found in case of plant Gynandropsis pentaphylla. Okay. So increase in the length of internode between first and second node, so it is called as anthophore. Increase in the length of internode between second and third node, it is called as androphore. Increase in the length of internode between third and fourth node, it is called as an gynophore. And if both the condition androphore and gynophore they are present in same flower, this condition it is called as an gynandrophore, or that condition it is also called as an androgynophore. And this condition it is found in case of plant Gynandropsis pentaphylla. Okay, so these are the terms you might not have studied. You have to remember from the point of NEET examination. What is mean by anthophore, what is mean by androphore, what is mean by gynophore, what is mean by gynandrophore as well as androgynophore. And you may also remember the example silene plant, dianthus. These are the plants in whose flower there is observation of anthophore condition. In case of Passiflora we observe androphore condition, in case of Caparis we observe gynophore condition, and in case of Gynandropsis pentaphylla we observe the condition that is called as gynandrophore, or it is also called as androgynophore. Gynandrophore or androgynophore means presence of both the conditions, anthophore, androphore as well as gynophore. Clear? Now, the first floral ball that is called as calyx. The unit of calyx it is called as sepal. Now, especially in case of Musenda plant. Now, one of the sepal, it represents that, or one of the sepal, it becomes leaf-like, it becomes attractive, as well as yellow-colored. Now, this sepal, it is also referred as advertising flag. This one of the sepal, it enlarges in size from other sepal. It becomes attractive yellow colored. It is leaf like. It is also called as advertising flag. Now, it is an adaptation found in case of Musenda plant in order to attract insects for the purpose of pollination. Okay, clear? Now, whatever character we have studied, now all these character, they show that flower, it is nothing but it is a modified shoot. Is it clear why flower it is called as modified shoot? Mainly due to presence of nodes as well as internodes, and presence of nodes and internodes, that is the characteristic feature of a stem. So flower it is considered as a modified shoot. Okay, moving on to another important terms you might have missed while studying 11th standard. Now, on the basis of flowering and fruiting, angiospermic plants that are classified into two different types. First, monocarpic plant, and second, polycarpic plant. Now, monocarpic plant, it usually includes annual and biennial plants. While polycarpic plant, it includes perennial plants. Now, the basis of flowering and fruiting plants are mainly classified as monocarpic plant, which includes annual as well as biennial plant. Now, annual plant means the plant which complete their life cycle in a year. Such plants are called as annual plant. Same, the plant which complete their life cycle in 2 years, such plants are called as an biennial plants. And perennial plants means the plants which survive for years and years, such type of plants are called as an perennial plant. Now, monocarpic plants means the plants which flower and fruits, or which produces or flowers and fruits once in their lifetime. Now, such type of plant they are called as an monocarpic plant. Aise plant jinko sirf ek hi bar phool aate, ek hi bar phal aata hai during their whole life, such type of plants they are called as an monocarpic plant. And second type of plants, polycarpic plant, the plants which produce flower and fruits many a times during their life. Such type of plants are called as an polycarpic plants. Okay, so remember, aise plants jinko sirf ek bar phool aur phal aate, aise plants ko hum log kya bolenge? Monocarpic plants. Aur aise plants jinko kafi bar flowers or fruits aate, aise plants ko hum log kya bolenge? Polycarpic plant. Now, exception to a perennial plant, for example, bamboo. Agave. Strobilanthus. Kunthiana. Bamboo, agave, strobilanthus, kunthiana, they are perennial plants. These plants, they are the perennial plants. Perennial means surviving for years and years. Now they are perennial plants, but they are monocarpic. Monocarpic means which produce flowers and fruits only once during the life cycle. Okay? And such plants, they are usually annual or biennial. But exception, bamboo, agave, strobilanthus, kunthiana. These are the plants which are monocarpic. Monocarpic means they produce flowers and fruits once during their life cycle, but not annual, not biennial. These plants, they are perennial. Perennial means surviving for years and years. Now, bamboo. It flowers once in its lifetime. And usually, flowering it takes place after 50 to 100 years. Now, once the age of bamboo it reaches to 50 to 100 years, once in its life cycle, it produces large amount of flower, large amount of fruit, and after producing flower and fruit, it dies. After producing large quantity of flower and fruit, after 50 to 100 years, this plant, it dies. Considering strobilanthus, kunthiana, also known called as Neela Kurunji. It is also called as an Neela Kurunji. Now, one of the characteristic feature following this plant. Now, this plant, it flowers after every 12 years. Or it flowers after 12 years. Once in a life cycle, once it crosses the age of 12 years. Now, flowering in this plant, it was observed in September, October 2006 in Kerala, Karnataka, and Tamil Nadu. As well as in Tamil Nadu. Now, when these plants, they flowered in October 2006 in Kerala, Karnataka, as well as Tamil Nadu, the complete hilly tracks, they were converted into blue stretches. मतलब जितने भी पहाड़ी रास्ते थे, उनके अगल-बगल में इन plants के जो flowers गिरे, जिस भी tracks पे गिरे, ये complete track, it was appearing to be blue in color, which attracted thousands of tourists visiting these places, especially to observe the blue colored tracks which were produced due to falling of flower of strobilanthus kunthiana. Okay, so these are the two different types of plants. On the basis of flowering as well as fruiting, the plants which produce flowers and fruits once during their life cycle, they are called as monocarpic. Many a times during their life cycle, they are called as polycarpic. Now, monocarpic plants, they are usually annual or biennial. Exception, bamboo, agave, strobilanthus, which are perennial. They are perennial, but they flower and fruit once during their life cycle. So these are the two different type of plants on the basis of flowering as well as fruiting. Okay, now whatever we have studied today, I think you have got everything. Just we will have a fast recap. We have started from science of flower. Science of flower, floriculture, correct? Cultivation, breeding and marketing of flower, it is called as floriculture. Now from Indian view, flower, it has an aesthetic, ornamental, then seasonal, sorry, cultural, religious, as well as social values. Now, in the view of a biologist, flower, it is a morphological as well as embryological marvel, and is especially a structure which is produced for the purpose of sexual reproduction. Now, definition of a flower, flower, it is a modified and condensed shoot. The evidences that flower, it is a modified and condensed shoot, it can be obtained from thalamus, which shows the presence of nodes as well as internodes. For the purpose of sexual reproduction, flower, it consists of two special organs. First organ, it is stamen, which acts as a male reproductive organ. And second organ, it is an carpel, which acts as a female reproductive organ. Actually, we will move on how sexual reproduction it takes place in case of flowering plants. And how sexual reproduction it takes place in case of flowering plant, that we will discuss in detail in the next video. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you enjoyed this video, primary, hit the like button and subscribe to the channel of Acharya Academy. Thank you.